Have you ever noticed that 200,000 people in Japan have died because of nuclear weapons? Greetings, my fellow classmates and my teacher, Mr. Abel. My name is Ponsarik Tipirak, or Tana, as you guys know. I am here to talk about why a country should own a nuclear weapons. Nuclear weapons were back in the First World War II, where USA created the project called Manhattan Project, where they need to create the weapons before the Germany does. Well, they create the weapons. That weapons killed 200,000 people in Japan, both in Hiroshima and Nagasaki in 1954. I am here to talk about the threats and the myth about nuclear weapons that people trust. Well, the threat starts after the Cold War, where England just dropped the bomb and the Russia drops the bomb. They fight each other for being the greatest country, as you guys know. And there's some myth about nuclear weapons. For example, people think that the threats of nuclear weapons are already gone, but no. Nuclear weapons still become one of the most frightened things where countries were afraid of. Second myth, well, it is a funny fact that security at the nightclub in Russia is more security than the nuclear weapons. They send the guards, you know, like five people at the nightclubs, but for the nuclear weapons, two. It's so easy to launch nuclear weapons at Russia. There's another fact about nuclear weapons. Well, America set hundreds of them, the launch code, to 5 digits of 0. You just press 0000. You can just launch a nuclear weapon and destroy a country. That's how easy it was, people. Countries should own nuclear weapons. It is really bad to have one of them. Well, they waste time to build a nuclear weapons, waste money to build nuclear weapons, and of course, destroy the environment. Well, there's a long-term effect where gamma rays destroy the whole entire part of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. They destroyed the environment. Over there, radiation was very high. Thank you for listening to me.